A very good afternoon to the respected jury, ladies and gentlemen. Before I start my presentation, let me start with my safety declaration that I always show in my behavior that safety is my topmost priority and inspire everyone to follow. Yeah. Just talking about our company, to give a brief, I am from TCAP, Toyota Kirloskar Auto Parts, and this company was established in 2002. Right now, it is a joint venture between Toyota Motor Corporation, that is Japan, Aishin Industries, that is also from Japan, and we have Kirloskar Systems from India. We have basically three plants, that is engine, transmission, and axle plant. And you can see on the screen our product portfolio. Whatever units we manufacture, that goes into the Toyota cars, that is starting from Fortuner, Hilux, Yaris, Etios, Innova, Crysta, not only for the domestic market, but also for the exports. The project that I'm going to talk about today is productivity improvement in transmission lines through quick setup change. Well, before I talk about the subject, what we have done, let me just give you a brief about why we have to go through this project. If you look at our business condition, in 2013, we ramped up our capacity, assuming that the market is going to expand for our product. However, 3-4 years, the market not expand, further the volume started going down. This had two major problems for us. One is, if you look at the impact, our fixed cost, that is depreciation, was increasing. The fixed cost was increasing. At the same time, this was putting tremendous pressure on our product cost. On the other side, the challenges that we had under this kind of a scenario was, one is we had a lot of projects which are coming up, like the transmission petrol line. We were supposed to put up a new diesel line. We were doing only petrol version. We were supposed to put up a diesel plant as well. So basically, two major problems, that is utilization, underutilization of the plant capacity, and there is significant investment which is required for our next projects. From now, I'll just try to tell you about our basic approach whenever we do a project. If you look at the slide, I just try to put some kind of presentation to make it easy to understand. We have an existing or current petrol line where the volumes are going down. Traditionally, when we have to put up a diesel line, then what we are supposed to do is, since it is a single piece production, we try to establish a new line altogether. So traditional approach is to new line for new diesel project. But when we looked at the investment for the new line, we found that it was very high. Sorry, I'm not able to put the figures here because of confidentiality reasons. But our management said, after looking at those figures, please reduce it by more than 50%. So it was very huge impact for us. So what is the common sense that we can think about? Obviously, how to utilize the capacity of the existing line and do both the diesel and petrol in the same line. So that's what we also decided to go ahead. Let me just give a little brief about what is the output that is required out of this when we talk about doing both the products in the same line. Just this slide demonstrates a little bit. I think I left my pointer on this one. Let me take a pointer. If you look at the slide, it is talking about a machining line, and then there is an assembly line. So what we require here is, assembly line should produce both diesel as well as petrol variants. And under Toyota production system, we cannot produce batch production. We have minimum inventories. We produce one after the other, that is called as Heijunka or level production. If assembly line has to produce one after the other, that means it is going to pull from the machining line at a random pace. It may pull a petrol or it may pull a diesel version. So the movement, if you see the diesel version, say for example, one of the variant, if it reaches the minimum stock, then we are supposed to do a setup change in the line. So that's where the setup change came into picture, that we had to do complete setup change of this particular line. Let's also see what is the kind of differences that we had between the petrol and the diesel. If you look at both the transmissions are overlapped there, size-wise, there's a lot of variation between both the transmissions. I put two of the parts to give a more clear picture. So if you look at the ring gear, it was more by around 25 millimeters. That was the kind of differences whatever we had. Again, the gear ratios are different. If you look at the shafts, more than 60 to 70 millimeters was the difference. So with this, if you had to do a setup change in this particular line to accommodate these kind of parts, I think all of you know, it requires longer downtime of the machines. For that, we need to develop a minimum loss line, or minimum setup change loss line. Just to talk a little bit about the scale of the project, This is our petrol line, that is manufacturing process of petrol, that is going through gear cutting operation. Then we have heat treatment, grinding, and then assembly. So this is the overall layout. This particular line has 28 loops or 28 cells, what we call, and it has 230 machines for making a petrol variant. If I have to do the diesel version in the same line, then I have to make more number of parts, because diesel has more number of parts in the same lines. As a summary, if you see, we have to have 33 loops and 285 machines that we need for the diesel. That means we have to utilize the existing lines to produce the diesel version on this particular line. So before I talk about what is that we try to do as a part of setup change, let me just give a brief about how the line runs on a single piece flow. I think this is for the interest of the people who have a batch production. We operate on a single piece flow. You can see the operator working. Basically, to produce one particular gear, it will go through six operations. What is written? OP 10, 20, 30. That is, it goes through lathe operations, broaching operations, hobbing, chamfering, and shaving. And you can see the operator, the one operator who is going through these six processes. He's loading and unloading parts in the different processes. It starts with the raw material, and the end product is the gear which comes out. So basically, if I have to change the variant from a petrol to a diesel, then in that case, I have to modify all the six machines to achieve the same part as an output of a diesel from petrol or vice versa. So the first important aspect for us is, what is the setup change time that we are going to achieve? How to fix the target? So what we try to do is, we try to look at our lines. If you see on the slide here, our current petrol line is running at an OA, overall availability or efficiency, of 92 to 93%, which we have achieved through various kaizens or improvements in the line. And our target, basically our global target, is 90% efficiency. So if at all I have to produce both petrol and diesel variant in the same line, then I still have to maintain the efficiency of 90%. That says that on a conservative side, I have around 2% or 2 to 3% of efficiency loss that I can handle. So with that thinking, we said on a conservative basis, we said, let's say 2% loss, that is equal to 10 minutes. Let's try to achieve the setup change of the complete line within 10 minutes is what we set a target. And we try to look at, on a conventional, traditional way, if you had to change the tooling exactly 1:1, whatever is running right now, it was coming to around 72 minutes of setup change. So the target was huge, 10 minutes for the complete line to go through a setup change. Right, so based on this, we made our KPIs very clear. We said we will try to achieve one touch setup wherever it is possible. Then, since the people are the ones who do the setup change, they cannot handle very heavy part. So we fixed some weight limits for the part to be handled. Then we said zero line stop, because existing line is running. So without stopping the line, we have to do this kind of operation. And the bottom graph shows we had so many different kind of processes, like the broaching, the lathe, the grinding, the pressing, the deburring, these kind of all the operations which have to undergo that the setup changes, which means a huge quantum of work. And the major part was the processes of like shaping, shaving, and hobbing, which are very critical in terms of gear accuracies, which goes to the tune of 2 to 8 microns, has to be handled. So the major challenge for us was, this is the first time in Toyota that the complete plant is going to undergo a setup change to produce a different variant. Otherwise, we had a little bit of experience of changing small parts or some small areas. So again, we did not have all the concepts available with our principal. So we summarized into three major challenges that we have to handle. One is, we need to do a complete plant modification. That is, 199 machines have to be handled for modification. And running change, that means with a minimum lead time of 6 months, we should not stop the line, running line. We have to change without disturbing the running line. And third is, we have to develop the skill of the people to be flexible to handle this kind of setup changes. Then the journey began. With this, we came out with some concepts. I brought some simple concepts which can be of interest to everyone. So if you look at lathe for OD clamping, basically, if I had to do different kind of parts on the lathe, what we try to look at is, we either try to change the complete chuck or the jaws. So we try to narrow down, saying that we'll only work on the jaws. We'll try to accommodate everything with the jaws. But again, traditional approach, if you see, we may have to look at completely removing the jaws from the lathe. So while doing brainstorming, we had various ideas. One of the ideas was like socket plunger mechanism. So socket plunger mechanism is the same wrench is used with multiple sockets, the ball plunger. So based on this thinking, we start developing a prototype, so new design, and we tested for the accuracies. Let me just demonstrate through some video here. So traditionally, if we have to do a setup change on a lathe to remove the jaws, we have to use a tool. We have to remove the bolts, remove the jaws, completely replace the jaws, and then we have to prove the accuracy. We came with a ball and plunger mechanism where we can just push or press fit on the check, all the jaws, and just start the machine. So these kind of concepts we could come out. And these kind of same ball plunger mechanism we try to do. Once we achieve the accuracy here, we try to do the yokoten or horizontal deployment in all the areas like jaws or datum blocks or pusher. With this, traditionally what was taking 10 minutes came to 2 minutes. Similarly, if you look at the, again, a lathe, which has to do a clamping with the collet, so it's much more challenging. There is a drawbar which pulls, and the moment you touch the collet, we have to prove the accuracy. So I think the people who are maintenance will understand much better. So here also we came with very simple concept of locking through a rotation, which I will demonstrate through a video. So traditionally here again, we have to remove the complete assembly, and then we have to replace the assembly. But however, if you see on the right side of the video, which is playing, just we can rotate the unit, and with the ball and plunger, we can lock the particular unit in position. With this, we were able to prove the accuracies. And again, this also came from a traditional 10 minutes to less than 2 minutes of the time. Let me also demonstrate some of the concepts going further. When it came to gear cutting, we tried to do a lot of brainstorming, but we were not able to come out with simpler ideas. Then we start benchmarking with our other affiliates and also local affiliates if they are doing some other activities. Then together with different kind of concept, we came to some specific concept. If you look at a gear setup for gear hobbing, the bottom fixture is mostly rigid. It is bolted completely to the machine, and because of the accuracies. So if I had to remove that setup, I had to completely dismantle the bottom setup, which is very heavy, and once you put it back, you need to prove the accuracies, which is very, very difficult part. So here we, in line with the same as the ID clamping mechanism, we try to change the concept of locking, that is clamping from the bottom. So with this concept, same as the lathe, we were able to change the top collet. So these kind of concepts worked for us, but here we went through a major challenge of static accuracy of the parts. So since the part accuracy we had to achieve less than 10 microns overall on the gear, with all the accuracies, the part accuracy should be less than 2 microns was a challenge, which we had to do a lot of trial and error to achieve this kind of an accuracy. So with this, the time reduced from 18 minutes to 8 minutes. These are some of the examples of the line changes, some examples. But however, not only that, we try to work in all the areas. It's not about only changing the tooling part of, I mean, the jaws or the fixture elements of the machine. Also the tools which we handle, like in a broaching application, broaching is nothing but making serrations inside the part, which is displayed there. So while handling the broach size is so, I mean, the weight is so heavy, it starts from 40 kgs, goes up to 120 kgs. Handling that by an operator is not easy. And if we try to use a lot of tackles and other things, the time increases. Here we try to do some benchmarking or brainstorming, thinking of using a swivel mechanism, how it is used on a tap. So I'll just demonstrate through a video. Here a heavy broach of around 90 kgs is loaded on the swivel mechanism. Currently he is changing the setup from a diesel version to a petrol version. He's changing the tool in the machine. You see he located the tool holder on the swivel mechanism. He has lowered the broach, which is around 90 kgs. So broach declamping is done on the machine. He has put it in position, then rotated the fixture to achieve a setup change for the broach. So the petrol version goes to the machine. So here the broach is clamped again. So once it is clamped, then the whole setup is put back to home position, and then the further setup changes are done to carry out this kind of trial. So we did kind of a lot of trial and error and a lot of designing these kind of concepts to achieve these things, and we could horizontally deploy to our other lines like the heat treatment shop or the gear tester. This significantly reduced our tool change time from 15 minutes to 3 minutes. Going further, on the machining side, we were talking about 10 minutes. However, the assembly line also has to run. So we cannot afford these kind of minutes on the assembly line because it runs a very high tack time. So here we had narrowed down based on our calculation that the setup change should be less than 5 seconds based on our timing. So some of the things which I'd like to demonstrate here. So on the assembly line, to handle the bigger parts, we need to have a lot of tackles which needs to be used for handling the parts. We try to see how we can do it on the same tackle. With the same kind of mechanisms, whatever we try to see there, we made simple mechanism here. So if you see, the operator here is trying to load a sub-assembly on the main assembly. So here, before I finish my talking, he has already changed the setup. So he has expanded the position and he has swiveled on particular mechanism to achieve the particular shape of the sling. So this kind of small things helped us to eliminate or have a same sling for many variants. Let's look at other mechanisms that we have developed. I think when we look at assembly, one of the major areas is the pallet, because the more variants you add to the line, we have to change the pallets, and pallet changing is not an easy job. So here also we try to look at how can we quickly change without changing the pallet, how can we commonize the pallet. So after a lot of workout, we came out with some simple mechanism where you can see by tilting mechanisms, we can change the pallet which can accommodate both the variants. If you see the video, he's changing the setup of the pallet. So if you see, the operator has done one change, 90 degrees, another, and a third change. That's all. Less than 5 seconds was requirement. Within 2 seconds, we could achieve. Just by changing the position of the datum block, we can achieve the setup changes on these kind of pallets. Well, this is how we try to look at a lot of solutions. We have come up with more than 300 solutions to achieve the complete setup change of all the areas. Now the question is, how do we achieve these mechanisms or changes within the 10 minutes time within the particular line? So if you look at the line, I'll just try to demonstrate. This is one particular line which is producing gear first to gear fourth. And if you look at when gear first triggers a setup change, each cell is operated by one operator. When it triggers a setup change, the operator of the line and the line support member who's supporting the line and the team leader come to the line, to that particular cell, and then those three people carry out the setup change. Now let me demonstrate how it happens. So if you look at, as I said, our target of 10 minutes, what we have to achieve. So with this, when we worked out on each process, we made sure that each process is less than 10 minutes of the setup change time. But however, with this, I require to change the setup of all the machines, I require 6 people to do at the same time. Here we did a little bit of Yamazumi balancing or the time balancing, and with that we were able to achieve with 3 people. Like, we made a very clear job plan, so operation 10 and 20 handled by one operator, and other 3 by another one, and one particular which is required around 8 minutes by one operator. With 3 members we were able to achieve the setup change. I mean, within 10 minutes, with 3 members we are able to do a setup change. So just a small video to just show that how actually it happens on the line. So these 3 people, the operator and the other 2 people, have come to the line and they are carrying out the setup changes. So basically, if you see, none of the operators are working with any tools. They're just pulling out parts from the machine and replacing with another parts on the machine. Then the machines are put in the setup and then they are started. That's how it operates. And if you see, one operator backside is trying to do something with the hoist and all. That's what was the beginning, what we did when we were handling the broach. Then we changed over to the swivel mechanism, which I tried to show you in my previous slides. So anyway, it was not that easy as I am trying to explain here. We had a lot of struggles in the journey. Like, we made a clear modification process plan from proving the static accuracy of the line to switching trials. That means how to get the first part okay. But the major things that we have gone through is the rigid fixture was changing to a flexible fixture, which calls for, which says a lot of accuracies are going to get disturbed. But we have to achieve the same accuracies. And we have to prove the quality in one shot, which was very difficult. Sometimes we have to do 2 to 3 iterations to get the correct quality and then redesign the particular blocks. And very important on the quality side, we have to achieve the process capability or the machine capability that we require out of 1.33. So not only this, like, while we were carrying out the activities, we came across with like a lot of hurdles. Like, we had a lot of interferences with the tools on the machines, for which we started immediately. The first machine, when we did, we had a problem, we start simulation trial so that we don't have this kind of problem with the other machine. We had a static accuracy problem with the jigs, what we got from our supplier. So we started the critical parameter inspection by ourselves. Then we had some wrong design selection, like springs and all, we were not able to design because of our capability. So we started doing some FMEA on the design to make sure that the next machine doesn't suffer that kind of things. So these kind of reflections we started documenting, and we start standardizing. So every problem that we face, we try to look at how we can reflect on our activities with this particular thing. So all the key points are added. So with this, our first challenge of 199 machines, we could look at all the kind of possibilities to do a setup change. The next task is, all this was done within a frame of 6 months. The lead time was very, very minimum. I'll just demonstrate what is that we did. So on the project schedule, everything has to be achieved within the 6 months. So we had to make a strategy how we are going to go ahead. Fortunately, if you look at our lines, for us as engineering, our lines were running in one shift operation. That is all 6 days, one shift operation. So whichever cell we were taking for the setup change, what we did is, we tried to do a little bit of inventory. That is, we tried to operate 3 days in two shifts instead of 1 week single shift. And based on that, we got 3 days available for doing the setup change for one particular cell. And we had a buffer of Sunday. That means around 2 to 3 machines is what we have to handle per day. So this is how we carried out our activities on the line. So with this we could manage with a lot of hurdles. And finally, people are supposed to carry out this kind of setup change. That is, human resource development is the key. So how to achieve the skill and flexibility? It's a running line. So we cannot touch the running line. So how do we change? So for that, when we looked at, what we did is we established a dojo. So now what is a dojo? Dojo is a Japanese word for a training center. So we made a training center, and basically to improve the skill of the people. Here our slogan was, every time same, everybody same. With this kind of understanding, we started training our members. And we made a clear objective that we cannot do a lot of adjustments after the setup change. The first time, the moment we do the setup change, the first part should always be okay. So with these concepts, with this kind of objectives, we started making our complete plan. This is some of the glimpses of dojo. It was not a very sophisticated dojo. We tried to replicate same as the machine. Can you go back? Yeah, same as the machine condition. The jigs were made in such a way that it is same as the machine. And we can see some of the videos where the person, he is doing the setup change in the dojo, in the training center. Here the intention is to achieve the muscle memory, because we cannot afford to go to the line and try to do these kind of activities. So with this, we try to achieve the muscle memory. If you look at the skill chart, as a summary, 80% of the skill we could achieve. That means both time and sequence, what is required in dojo, we could achieve. And remaining 20%, we try to focus through on-job development, that is going to the machine, because the actual condition of the machine, whatever we try to simulate, was a little different. Like if you see one of the cases, we try to do as a reflection, same guard as a machine with a cardboard. And he tried to see whether it's going to interfere, how difficult it is for ergonomic wise. And a lot of suggestions came up through this kind of a dojo. Yeah. So basically, that's what we did. And if you see as the result, overall results, we could achieve the changes with zero accidents and zero incidents on the quality, whatever parameters we fixed, that is machine capabilities of more than one we could achieve in all our areas. And then accuracy of the first part, we could, with a lot of switching trials, we came to a conclusion that we had to achieve 80% of the tolerance band. The moment we do a setup change, it should lie within 80% of the tolerance band. It cannot be outside the tolerance band. So with this, quality also was okay. And the major portion, that is setup change time. Traditionally, if you'd have carried out the activity, it would have costed us 43.55 hours on a cumulative basis to do the whole plant setup change. With these kind of mechanisms, we were able to arrive at 6.15 hours, that is 86% is what we could reduce. And if you look at the efficiencies, before the modification or after the modification, there was a drop of 1 or 2% as per calculations, but however, we were able to achieve within our set target of 90 minutes. Right. So, other part of it, the major portion was on the investment. So, investment we could reduce more than 51%, so the tunes of around 60 to 65 crores. Basically, this helped us in a lot of value creation in the line. So if you see, earlier we were making only petrol version or with this kind of setup. Now our lines are flexible to carry out any kind of volume fluctuations. Also, we can add any kind of variant on the line. And on the environment front, a lot of things we could save in terms of CO2. But however, when we talk about energy, because we commonize the machines, the idling time, the coolant, such things we were able to eliminate. With that, we were able to see that 42% of the energy we could reduce on these particular lines. Basically, our line is now ready for the future for any kind of variant that can come on the line. As an overall achievement, with the three objectives that I tried to demonstrate in the beginning, so basically, we could modify all the 199 machines out of our plan. We could achieve the 6 months of lead time for this. And on the human resource, we set up some parameters for improving even the skill of our engineers. That also we try to validate and check based on our activity. As a part of further value creation, so if you look at it all happened in the seat transmission line. So we don't have opportunity for doing setup changes in other plants like our transmission or the engine or the axle line. But however, we use these concepts to make our loading, unloading, such kind of areas easy for our operator to do. So with this, we were able to carry out Yokoten. And these concepts, whatever we developed, we were able to share with a lot of our other Toyota affiliates all across the globe. Now these are being tried out or being used in other affiliates as well. So it was the first time in Toyota that the whole plant has undergone the setup change. So basically, this is what we did as a part of the setup change. But our journey doesn't end here. So while we were doing this activity, in 2016, we tried to talk a little bit about Karakuri, that is the low-cost automation for doing our activities. So what we did is, while we were carrying out the setup change activity, so whatever setup change ideas that we were generating, we started utilizing these ideas in our low-cost automations. And same time, the low-cost automation, we started assisting the operator to save his time so that we carry out the setup change, like whatever two additional people that has to go to the line for setup change are all compensated with the same people who are there. So we try to reduce these kind of things. Some of the automations that were done on a very low cost are displayed here. So going ahead with this, because we wanted a lot of ideas from people, because ideas cannot come from one person, so the power of thinking is what is most important for anyone. So based on that, what we try to do is, we try to establish a Karakuri workshop for people, where people can come out with different kind of ideas. And we started with a learn with fun concept, with 3 days curriculum, where we talk about theory, and then practical, I mean actual checking on the shop floor, and then practical. So based on this particular thing, so we were able to get a lot of ideas. At the same time, there was a lot of inquiries from other affiliates to learn on these concepts. So we started a complete classroom for our other supplier partners as well to educate them on these mechanisms. In the same time, we have got benefit by getting a lot of ideas from them when they went through our curriculum. So we were also able to use these kind of ideas in our thing. So this is what is about my overall activity about the setup change. Basically, if you look at in the morning session, Mr. Murugam said that productivity is not an activity, it is a culture. So I also believe, we also believe the same. We say that it's not a destination, it is a journey of continuous improvement. So basically, this is also one of our steps towards our vision, that is TCAP's vision of win India, win the world, and to become the most admired manufacturer of ever better units. This concludes my presentation on the setup change. So if you have any questions or suggestions, I'll be very keen to answer or take.